In this video, we will go over the best smart home automation ideas, ones that are actually helpful, and avoid the ones you'll pay a bunch of money for and never really use. There are five basic parts of home automation. One, a device that acts as a trigger, like a motion detector. Two, a device that completes an action when triggered, like a smart vacuum cleaner. Three, a device that can do both, like a door lock. It can be locked by something triggering it, or locking it can trigger something else. Four, apps that get everything and all the devices to work together and do a sequence of actions. I only use devices that work with three apps, the Stringify app, the IFTTT app, and the SmartThings app. And five, a hub for all the devices to communicate with so it can then communicate with these three smart apps. In my home, I mostly use the SmartThings hub. Let's start with my door sensors because in my home, they are the most consistent triggers. They work almost 100% of the time, which makes them very reliable and really effective. My favorite use for them is in my balcony sliding door. I have it set to turn on my outdoor strip lights to a blue color every time someone opens the door, but I preset Stringify to do this only at nighttime. Now, you don't have to use the door sensor to control them. You can also use the SmartThings app or any trigger device that works with any of these three smart apps. Now, these same type of door sensors can also turn on my pantry light every time I open the pantry door. It is really helpful, as this is one of the lights people forget to turn off all the time. And I know I want my pantry light to turn on every time I am in the pantry. The pantry lights turn on by triggering my smart light switch. So I can still also use the light switch to toggle them on and off too. As another idea, you can use your door sensors on your window for security and hook them up to an alarm siren. This helps to keep intruders out and can in some cases keep sneaky teenagers in. This works because the siren is also a smart device. The siren works as a good deterrent because it has a strobe effect as well as the siren that goes off. If you don't want the siren going off every time you open the window, in Stringify, just set them to go off only during certain hours or when your house is set in away mode, and I'll explain that in a little bit. Now, this is my favorite smart home device, and this might surprise a lot of people. It is a smart outlet with a power button on the front. It really takes your smart home to the next level. The beauty of this device is that you can turn most dumb things into smart things. For example, if you plug this normal humidifier into a smart outlet, you can now turn it on and off a variety of ways, from the SmartThings app, your voice, on a schedule, or use whatever other trigger you want to turn it on with. But you can also just turn it on and off from the power button on the outlet. And this is really important if you have people that won't be comfortable with smart appliances. This is one of two important reasons for the power button on the outlet. Take the space heater, for example. You can start heating a room up in the morning before you even get out of bed by telling Google Home or scheduling it in Stringify, pressing on in the SmartThings app, or just press the physical button on the outlet itself. In fact, you can smart control the on and off to almost any device that you can turn on and off by just plugging it in. Let me explain. This fan is turned on. I unplug it, then I plug it back in, and it is still turned on. Therefore, this smart outlet can make this fan smart. Contrarily, this second fan I have is turned on, but when I unplug it, then plug it in again, it doesn't automatically turn back on. So this device won't become smart with the smart outlet. I have found this to be particularly useful with curling irons in the house. For example, you can have them on a timer in Stringify that once you turn them on, they will automatically turn off in 30 minutes. You could still make sure you didn't leave it on and off from wherever you are in the world, so you don't have to worry about always leaving a curling iron on. As you can see, you can take almost any of your electric devices and make them somewhat smart. I even plug my washer and dryer into the outlet. Let's say I want to turn on the washer an hour before I come home so my clothes don't sit wet all day. Or let's say I want a hot blanket ready when I get home on a cold night. I don't know, do whatever you want. That's the point. And here is something crazy. You can even turn a normal TV into a smart TV with just this outlet. I did this with my old TV in my garage gym. Then I hooked up a Chromecast to it, and it pretty much is a fully smart TV now. More to come on that in just a bit. Now, like I said, once a device is hooked into my SmartThings network, any device can trigger another. So I can literally just use this smart outlet button as a smart switch for anything else. Look at this outlet. It has no device plugged into it. Yet I use Stringify so I can turn on this other light that is plugged into a different smart outlet by pressing the button of the outlet with nothing plugged into it. So this means in the morning from my bed, I can just press a button near my bed to start up my coffee maker. In fact, this coffee maker wasn't even a smart coffee maker until I hooked it into this outlet as well. If you want to get really fancy, look how nothing is plugged into this smart outlet. Yet I can literally turn on and off all these lights and devices, including my fireplace, by just tapping a button. It can do this because this is a preset I made in the Stringify app. The more you become familiar with SmartThings, IFTTTT, and Stringify, the more stuff like this you can do. And it's not that hard. Now, okay, in Google, this video, I just did that by pressing lights. A button. But actually, in my house, this is my light setting preset for when guests come over. I turn them on not with a button, but with my voice sensor. You probably don't call them a voice sensor, though. You probably call them Alexa or Google Home. But when it comes to home automation, to me, these are just sensors that use your voice to trigger actions. Most of my house is set up to do certain action sequences in response to my voice command. My fireplace is something I always use to turn on and off with my voice. In fact, it is one of the only devices I use that doesn't have a physical switch or toggle on and off. To be honest, I had to rig it that way because my fireplace could only use a special device to plug it into the system to make it smart. Your fireplace may be different. I will link to this device along with every device I talk about in this video below in the description. And since it now works with the three smart apps, anything including my phone can control it. I also use my voice sensor to turn on and off my whole garage gym by simply saying it's workout time. It turns on my garage lights, TV, fan, and my garage door. This is the beauty of having everything set up with the big three smart apps: SmartThings, IFTTT, and Stringify. And I normally don't get any devices that don't connect to at least one of those three apps. Because if I do, I cannot plug them into a string of events like I did here with my garage gym setup. I do have two devices that are exceptions that I don't use with those three apps. The first is my dog feeder. I have it feed my dogs twice a day, and I never worry about feeding my dogs besides that. It even informs me if there happens to be an error or doesn't feed them for some reason. You can also control the smart feeder with your voice, its app, or a button on it. I like my smart feeder because it's the best one on the market, but I don't love it because it doesn't connect to any of the three smart apps. In fact, post below if you know one that does. The next thing I control on a time schedule is my smart vacuum. It's nice to have a freshly vacuumed house every morning, especially with shedding pets. Now, when we have guests coming outside of the schedule, I can still control it with its own app or Alexa. I love this vacuum because it both vacuums and mops. Okay, if you're ready, I'm going to show you something that has changed my life. I now control everything on my TV with my voice through Google Home. To do this, I subscribe to YouTube TV to replace our cable. I then connected my TV to Chromecast and also set up the Logitech Hub. This hub controls my TV better than my SmartThings Hub. Using Google Home, I am then able to completely replace the need for the remote, and I just tell the TV what show or channel I want to watch, or how long to rewind, or what time or second in the show I want to skip to. All other smart TV combinations at this point are not as good as this setup. I have another video that gives you more specifics on this. I will post that video at the end of this one. And don't worry, you can still use your phone app too to control and surf the TV as well. You don't have to use your voice. The biggest expense I have for my smart home automation are my smart light dimmer switches. I literally switched out every light switch in my house with a smart dimmer switch. Here you can see I control my chandelier with my dimmer switch to turn them on and off and to increase or decrease the brightness. In case you aren't already getting the pattern in this video, I can also use my voice or any other trigger to turn them on or control them. People ask why I use smart dimmer switches instead of buying smart light bulbs. First, expensive smart light bulbs you have to replace when they die or break. Second, people always turn the light switches off that control smart light bulbs, and they don't work if the light switch is off. Third, people that are SmartThings illiterate can still turn on and off the lights without even knowing the difference if you use smart dimmer switches. Like the outlet button, what is cool about these switches is that you can have them turn on any device or string of actions you have preset. Here you can see I can turn two separate lights on with one switch. That entry lamp is controlled with a smart outlet. So now one switch turns on all my lights in my entryway. Or if I want to, that switch can control something completely else as well. I could even unscrew the light bulb and control just the entry lamp with the switch, or really any other device I wanted. For example, that light switch can now control my space heater or turn on all my gym lights if I wanted to control it that way. I do have some smart light bulbs in my home, but those are in areas mostly where I want to switch the color and tone of the light and not just the brightness. So with smart white light bulbs, you can switch the tone of the white light. I can make the lights more yellow and subdued and romantic, or more bluish, which makes things feel more clean and bright. If all you want to do is change the white tone, I recommend these bulbs. They are less expensive, and I will link to them like everything else in this video below. Then there are smart colored light bulbs. If you go with color lights, I recommend going with Philips Hue light bulbs. Their lighting apps are far superior and make the lights do all sorts of tricks. Like I can set them as pulsing Christmas lights, or a fiery lava ambiance, or even give them a lightning bolt effect, or I can have them match the colors that are on my TV. And there are tons of third-party apps that can do much more impressive stuff than even these ideas. Osram bulbs are like Philips Hue, but they're cheaper and have some different types of bulbs that Philips Hue doesn't. But once again, both work with SmartThings to simply change the color of the light. Arrival or presence sensors are the next smart thing that I use. First off, they can work as a beeper to help you find your keys. Very helpful to me. But they are meant to detect whether you are present or away from your home. I use them in the past when I have to leave town. I attach them to my dog's collar and they notify me in case my dog gets out. Stringify sends me a notification the dog is missing if they pass outside the certain present area. Then I can let the dog sitter know right away if my dog escapes. I also use my arrival sensors to turn on my outside lights as soon as I get home. And some people use them as a way to make sure their garage is closed by getting a notification of the garage door status when your sensor is detected that you're away from home. I use them mostly as a conditional device in Stringify. Let me explain what that is. In Stringify, you can have lights turn on, let's say, on the condition that it's nighttime. But with these presence detectors, you can have things only happen on the condition that you are home or away, whichever you desire. Here's an example. My front door locks at 10:30 every night if all my presence detectors are in present mode. Or in other words, if everyone is home at my house. Or my windows being open only triggers an alarm if all my sensors are set to away, meaning my sensors are outside of the detectable presence. Like presence or arrival sensors, I can use my phone's GPS to detect when I have entered or left a larger area than just my home. I use this to trigger my smart thermostat. When my phone enters or leaves a radius from my home, I can have the thermostat turn on or off. This is good because my thermostat can start cooling my house a few miles before I get home from work, instead of right as I arrive or being turned on all day. I set this up in the IFTTT app. I recommend other smart thermostats than my own, but this was the only smart one that worked with my house's warranty. But since it works with SmartThings, I can still use my voice, phone, schedules, or other devices to control my thermostat. But back to my point, you can sort of use your phone's GPS much like an arrival sensor. Both have a few different advantages and disadvantages. My smart doorbells are another life-changing device. I can see who is at my door anywhere in the world to decide if I want to answer or not. This is awesome. We don't even have to leave the bed to see if we want to answer the door. Also, this device has both a doorbell and motion detector on it that work as triggers because this works with SmartThings as well. So, this records any time there is motion or the doorbell is pressed. But because this also hooks up to SmartThings, you can use it to turn on the lights when motion is detected at night. Or you can be fancy and have it change the light color when the doorbell is pressed. I like this doorbell better than the Ring doorbells, even though Ring is more popular. I think it looks better and it doesn't require a monthly fee like Ring does. And a link to that doorbell is found below this video. Despite what these doorbell companies claim, they are not that good at catching thieves or for security purposes. I don't really use it as my security camera. Watch my video on security camera setups if you want to know the best way to do a setup for cheap without a monthly bill and find the best camera and position for security purposes. But also, while I love my security cameras, I don't really use them for smart home reasons, which is why the smart doorbell camera is so useful. My smart door lock is another life changer. I don't even know where the keys to my front door are at anymore because I don't ever use them. I just plug my code in and it locks and unlocks my front door. Also, on my phone, I can unlock the door from anywhere I want in the world as well. However, my door lock is also a smart triggering device. I have my entry lights come on whenever I unlock the front door at nighttime. Also, I have a routine when I tell Google Home that I'm leaving. It waits 20 seconds, enough time for me to leave, and it turns everything off. It sets my thermostat and it locks my front doors. Okay, now we move on to motion sensors, though we already sort of just talked about the one on my doorbell. Most people want to use motion sensors to turn things on, and I do use them to turn on my closet lights. I also use them to turn on the night lights in my kitchen if they sense movement, but only after the hour of 12 a.m. However, I find motion detectors more useful in turning off devices. For example, turning off my closet light if no motion is detected for 10 minutes after they've been on. Or closing my garage door if there's no motion in the garage for 20 minutes, and so forth. These can really cut your electricity bill if used right. I found them also to be useful in areas and times you want to be notified if there's movement. You can have it trigger your siren alarm when you are on vacation and there is movement in your bedroom or somewhere in your house. Or receive an alert if someone enters your room when you're gone to work. You can put one wherever you hide the Christmas presents or on the stairs if you have a crawling baby and you want to be warned in those moments. Next is the wet sensor. People use this to put under their sinks or near their washer so they can catch a leak before it gets really bad. I have found a more frequent use though. Now, I have tested this out and found that you can use it to catch the person peeing on the toilet seat. I put mine on the toilet seat and it can notify me whenever it senses the wetness of urine, but also when the pee is no longer detected, hopefully meaning they cleaned it up. Okay, back on a serious note. These multi-purpose sensors that I will link to below not only work as open door sensors and temperature sensors, but also vibration and tilting sensors. They are really good. They sense the slightest movement, both when I hit the counter or just kind of tap on it. Attach this to the baby crib and you will be alerted when they are awake and start moving. For me, I have it set to trigger and turn on a red light when the baby is awake. Also, you can attach them to trash cans so you know when animals are getting into the trash, as the trash cans will start to vibrate or tilt. You can then either have it turn on a light to scare them away or send you a notification to catch them in the act. Let me now show you my favorite cascade of events that I have my smart home do. After I give Google the command, time for bed, all my lights turn off, my front door locks, my thermostat changes, and the garage door closes if I forgot to close it before. This footage comes from my video showing Google Home automation in real time. If you want to see how fast this all can happen, give it a watch. Once again, every device I use is found in the description below this video. If this video helped you out, give it a like and subscribe to the channel. In the comments, let me know of any better devices you find, questions you have about smart home automation, or helpful smart home videos you want to see made.